I'm going to briefly describe how to use an interactive simulation that starts with a vapor liquid binary mixture in equilibrium. And the mixture is an ideal mixture of normal hexane and normal octane. And on the left is shown a snapshot from the simulation where liquid is present. This is the number of moles of liquid. And then the mole fraction is 0.43. for hexane, and then the vapor is enriched in hexane, and this is the number of moles of vapor. So this represents a piston and cylinder, and then what the simulation does, it allows you to add moles to the system at constant temperature and constant pressure. So when you click the play button here, these moles will be injected into this piston and cylinder, and you have the option of either adding in hexane or in octane. If you select the PXY button, then you display the starting condition and then also the final conditions when you hit play. So we start at this point, vapor liquid mixture, but very close to the liquid line. It's 17.5 moles of liquid, only 2.5 moles of vapor. The simulation's objective is to help you understand Raoult's law, vapor liquid equilibrium binary mixtures. The simulation is available online on the Wolfram Demonstration Project site, and the location is given here. So now let's go and look at this simulation. So here's the interactive simulation, and we can move the slider, change the number of moles that we add. And let's add a large number of moles. Important thing to note is that the saturation pressure of octane is less than that of hexane, and so you should be able to first predict what's going to happen when I inject the normal octane into the system. And so now if I hit play, notice we only have liquid present, and we can understand that by looking at the PXY diagram. So let me reset. We started in vapor liquid equilibrium, but very heavily towards the liquid side, the blue line corresponding to the boundary between the liquid phase and vapor liquid equilibrium. And so when I inject this much octane, I move, because octane has a lower saturation pressure, I move to all liquid. If I instead inject hexane, I move in the other direction. And the idea is that you can use this to help understand behavior for vapor liquid equilibrium.